Welcome, friends, to this episode of Transformational Breathworks. In the last episode, we had discussed about 2:1 breathing. First, we had discussed about even breathing, then we went on to learn how to do 2:1 breathing. 2:1 breathing is one of the most important signs, good sign of a breath. We need to learn to incorporate slowly this into our lifestyle. As we have already discussed, 90% of us have got exhalation time which is shorter than the inhalation time. So first we have to work on the exhalation time and make it 1:1, then slowly over a period of say 3 to 4 months, we have to make it into 2:1. Why our exhalation is shorter? Many of the time, it is because of the weakening of the respiratory muscles. So in our future episodes, we are going to learn how to strengthen the respiratory muscles. First we will learn what are those respiratory muscles, important respiratory muscles, and then how to strengthen them. Today we are going to touch upon a very interesting aspect of a breath, that is exhalation. Exhalation is breathing out, prasavash. So we will touch upon two very interesting techniques, how we can lengthen our exhalation. As we all know, till the time we are exhaling or breathing out, our bronchioles, they remain open. And till the time they remain open, we can throw out the toxins which are produced inside our body. So, lengthening of exhalation is a must if we really want to throw out the toxins. When we are unable to throw out the toxins, they keep depositing, and over a period of time, this leads to various disorders or diseases. This can be physical or mental. Another important aspect is it causes an obstacle for our spiritual progress. If our exhalation is shorter, we will not be able to take charge of our mind. Another important aspect of longer exhalation is when the exhalation is longer, then we activate that part of the nervous system which makes us stress-free. Today we are going to touch upon two ways of lengthening the exhalation. As you all know, respiratory rate is proportional to the age, to our longevity. If the respiratory rate is less, then our lifespan is more. As we all know, we have seen in the nature, mosquitoes, their respiratory rate is very, very high. Dogs, cats, even they have got a very high respiratory rate. Their lifespan is very, very less. Mosquito lives hardly for 7 to 10 days. Dogs, cats for 10, 15 years. And on the other side of the spectrum, whale, tortoise, elephant, their respiratory rate is much less. Hence, their longevity is much more. So friends, if we learn the art of increasing the length of exhalation, then we can make sure that our respiratory rate comes down. Respiratory rate is nothing but inhalation plus exhalation. That means breathing in time plus breathing out time. If we can increase both, or only exhalation, then we will make sure the respiratory rate goes down. And if the respiratory rate is down, then we can increase our lifespan, increase the longevity. Friends, as we all know, mind has got two components. One is the conscious part of the mind, second is the unconscious part of the mind. It is much easier to control the conscious part of the mind. It is much difficult to control the unconscious part of the mind. And by taking care of the exhalation, if we lengthen our exhalation, then we can make sure that we are able to take charge of our unconscious part of the mind also. We have to take charge of both the parts of the mind, conscious as well as unconscious. But unconscious part of the mind can be evaluated, can be seen, can be taken care of only if we know how to lengthen our exhalation, because that is also going to help us in our meditation. So friends, what are the two techniques which are going to help us in lengthening the exhalation? First one is known as purse string or straw breathing. You have seen the purse string. In old days, ladies used to carry the purse string, money bag. You remember, if you stress the strings, if you pull the strings apart, then the mouth used to close. And if you used to loosen the strings, then the mouth used to remain open. It's something like this. Purse string is, you have to breathe through your nose and you have to breathe through your mouth, as if it is the opening of the purse. Normally it is like this. If you pull the strings, it becomes like this, something like this. So you have to inhale, in this technique you have to inhale through the nose and exhale through the mouth, and shape of the mouth has to be like this. You are giving a sort of obstruction to the outflow of the air when you are breathing out. Here you breathe in through the nose, again see, this is purse string method of breathing. This makes sure that your exhalation is lengthened, and once you keep practicing like this, then you will be activating those muscles which are used in exhalation. They will get strengthened, and when they get strengthened, then you can prolong your exhalation as much as you want, of course within limits. This type of technique, this technique is also called as straw breathing. Again see, straw breathing means when you inhale through the nose and you breathe out as if you are holding a straw in your mouth. So this method is known as purse string breathing or straw breathing. Now friends, we are going to learn another technique which is very common, which we all are familiar with, but we are not aware that, oh, this is the technique we are talking about. This technique is known as exhalation breathing. This technique is based on your speaking power. What is that? You can speak only during exhalation. You can never speak during inhalation. You know, vocal cords which are present here, they are V-shaped like this. So when you exhale, normally in inhalation, exhalation. They are open during inhalation, they are open during exhalation. But when you speak, then what happens? These two vocal cords, they move nearer to each other. And there are various hundreds of configurations which are possible when they move near to each other. And when they move near to each other, during the outflow, during the exhalation, what happens? It obstructs the normal flow of air. As a result of this, a sound is produced. This is how we produce the alphabets A, B, C, D. There are different configurations of the vocal cords. A, B, C, D. Different configurations are made when we speak different alphabets or different words or different letters. So you can speak only during exhalation. So what happens? You have to speak something. For that, you can chant any mantra. Like you can chant Omkar, easiest. You can chant Soham. You can chant anything. You can speak anything that will affect only the exhalation part. So when you are effectively speaking or chanting, what happens? You are giving obstruction to the outflow of the air. Just see. This is what we do when we do Bhramari Pranayama. Bhramari. This is Bhramar. Bhramar is again, that is a sound produced by the B. That is known as Bhramar. That's why it is known as Bhramari. So we have to speak like this. So just see. Inhale. Normal inhalation through the nose. While exhaling, you have to chant. So when you are speaking, which can be done only during exhalation, you are basically giving obstruction to the free outflow of the air from the lungs. So this is another way of increasing the length of exhalation. Any chanting. Let's say we will try Omkar chanting. Inhale through your nose. Om. Akar chanting, Ukar chanting, Makar chanting, Omkar chanting, or for that any of the mantras. You know, this technique used to be taught to the students in the Gurukulas in olden days. Why? Because there used to be very, very lengthy mantras so that they could speak in one exhalation those mantras. That is how they used to use the increase in the length of exhalation. They used to chant longer mantra. The longer the mantra is, longer exhalation they used to have. So, if you want to increase the length of exhalation, you start chanting mantra, longer mantra. Start with a shorter mantra. First you can start with Omkar, then maybe you can go into Gayatri chanting. Slowly you can increase the length of the mantra. Thus you can increase the length of the exhalation. You can speak anything, you can speak your name also. Because exhalation, you can speak only in exhalation. So, my dear friends, we have learned the two techniques today. First one was pulse string or straw breathing. Second was chantings. You can speak only in exhalation. So, these are the two techniques. If we learn these two techniques, then we can make sure that the length of exhalation is much more as compared to the length of inhalation. And length of the exhalation leads to our being stress free. We are able to see our unconscious part of the mind. We can take charge of our emotions. So friends, this is very, very important. We all know that fifth of the good sign was 2:1 breathing. How to do the 2:1 breathing? And another important aspect is, if we increase the length of inhalation and exhalation, then we automatically bring the respiratory rate down. Respiratory rate less means we are increasing our lifespan. Friends, I hope you are enjoying these sessions. You are learning the art of incorporating them into your lifestyle, because we all do walking. So friends, let's say I do inhalation in 3 steps, then I can make sure that I do exhalation in 3 steps. Inhalation 3 steps, exhalation 3 steps. That will make it into even breathing, samana shwas. Then slowly, once I am comfortable with this walking, then I can increase the length of exhalation. How? 3 steps inhalation, 4 steps exhalation. When I am comfortable with this, then I can make it 5 steps exhalation, 6 steps exhalation. 6 steps means it becomes 1:2. When I am comfortable with 3 steps inhalation and 6 steps exhalation, then I make it into 4 and 8. So this way I can make sure that I increase the length of inhalation as well as I increase the length of exhalation. So friends, thank you very much. In the next episode, I am going to discuss with you an important technique which helps in increasing the length of inhalation as well as exhalation. That is going to be part of the Viloma Pranayama. Hope to see you very soon. Another request, please like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel AGP Breathworks. Thank you very much.